breaking news out of North Korea. It's not good at all. A North Korea official has threatened the U.S. yet again, promising its own mode of counteraction if the U.S. takes part in joint military exercises with South Korea in the coming months, Fox News reports. A spokesperson for North Korea's foreign ministry said Saturday that the drills between the U.S. and the South would harm reconciliation efforts on the peninsula, and that the North would be forced to counter the U.S., Reuters reported. The U.S. is expected to take part in joint military exercises with the South starting in April. If the U.S. finally holds joint military exercises while keeping sanctions on the DPRK will counter the U.S. by its own mode of counteraction and the U.S. will be made to own all responsibilities for the ensuing consequences. North Korea's official KCNA. The United States placed its largest package of sanctions on North Korea on February 23, in what some see as the last political effort to force North Korea to give up its nuclear programs, ICBMs and warheads. President Trump warned that this has two stages and if North Korea forces the second stage, it would be very, very unfortunate for the world. North Korea has said they were open to talks with the United States but that they would not beg and the United States said they were open to talks but only if it is to abolish the DPRK's nuclear programs. Reuters reports that the North said that it will never give up, end or agree to any conditions about their nuclear programs. Whether peace desired by our nation and the rest of the world settles on the Korean Peninsula or a situation that no one desires is developed in the vicious cycle of confrontation depends on the attitude of the United States. The latest sanctions placed upon North Korea, according to President Trump, are the heaviest ever placed on a nation. "We impose today the heaviest sanctions ever imposed on a country before. Hopefully, something positive can happen," President Trump. According to Forbes, this latest batch of sanctions targeted one individual, 27 entities and 28 vessels, many of which are located outside of geographic North Korea. Treasury's Office of Foreign Assets Control, OFAC, also issued a global shipping advisory, increasing the risk of doing business with North Korean ships that engage in deceptive practices such as ship-to-ship transfers of various spent materials, including refined fuel and coal, in an attempt to evade U.S. and international sanctions. In addition to targeting North Korean entities, new sanctions target Chinese entities that help Pyongyang avoid the bite of sanctions. In spite of China's verbal commitments to support and uphold U.S. and international sanctions against North Korea, it has often come to the aid of its ally. It has become commonplace to hear that North Korea has threatened the United States and President Trump has responded with some form of tough rhetoric and then we place sanctions and North Korea ignores them. Fox News reports that China won't tolerate an unprovoked attack on North Korea, and President Moon will not support the use of South Korean forces as part of a U.S. military strike against North Korea. President Trump further indicated that he is considering a preventive military strike on the North if the sanctions fail to denuclearize the communist nation. But such a so-called bloody nose strike against North Korean missile sites and nuclear facilities stands an excellent chance of becoming a bloody disaster. Blunt truth, China is protecting North Korea and allowing the North to amp up their nuclear facilities and warheads. Is the United States afraid of China, to the point we will allow a nation to create nuclear bombs that they promise to use against the United States? We all know sanctions and tough talks are nothing more than hot air and something must be done to stop North Korea. Is President Trump's administration all smoke and mirrors or do they have a plan?